When I had finished the series, I started, well, when maybe 60 or 70% of the images were ready, I had been sending those to my gallery, that gallery where I showed the spam series, with no answer. They would never reply to my emails and to the images. And when 60 or 70% of the series was ready, the exhibition was supposed to open in September. And by the end of April, they emailed me, well, they called me, and they told me that they were not going to show the series because they thought it was a step back in my language and that it was out of the market. So it was obviously a very hard coup for me because I had quit my job. I really wanted to concentrate on this more conceptual and personal work. And obviously I was relying on the gallery, but with the first attempt, they told me they didn't like it. I obviously thought that the story was good. I was having so much fun doing it, and I didn't agree on the decision of the gallery. So maybe because I needed to have good feedback on the series and somebody to tell me that you're not completely crazy, just quit your job and to do this crazy story and it's not good, I started sending the series to all the competitions there were. All of them. I think I applied to all of them. I spent a fortune because now it's very expensive to submit your series to any competition. But I started getting good feedback from all of them. I won one grant and it was selected in many competitions as a winner or second winner. And at some point there was this sort of festival that is not happening anymore in Spain. It's a sort of portfolio reviews, but open portfolio reviews. They give you a table, they select 30 photographers and a big space, and they give you a table and you just do like a market. And they call a lot of curators and editors and gallerists, and just the gallerists and the people, the reviewers, just move around and talk to the artist on the other side of the table. So, the curator of a museum that is, again, in a university in southern Spain, not a very famous university, a very small one. They don't have a very big show or museum at all, but they do have a program that is called Cuadernos Cursala, that is Cursala Notebooks, Cursala being the name of the museum. And they are one of the very few initiatives there is to support emerging photographers in Spain. And they have worked with many young photographers in Spain. What they do is that they give you 2,900 euros to produce an exhibition and to make a catalog. You have to give them 400 copies of the catalog. So it is not that they are actually helping you a lot, because with this money you have to produce an exhibition and print 400 catalogs and then you have nothing. But what they do with these catalogs is to give it and to send it to all the journalists, to curators, to everything. So they actually promote your work in a very specific way. Jesús Micó, who's that person, approached me and asked me if I wanted to do the next Cuaderno Cursala. And this is how I decided I was going to do a book. I already knew that I needed a book, because I had been collecting all sorts of materials and documents and generating documents that could put some balance in the fantasy of the story just by the images. So I needed to compensate that with real documents so I could really play the game with fact and fiction. I needed a book, and then I had the chance to getting this person asking me if I wanted to do a book, not in very good economic conditions, but they gave me a deadline, and I am used to work with deadlines.
Ok, quindi quando avevo quasi finito di fare il mio libro, appunto, e il 60-70% delle foto erano pronte, ho scritto alla galleria che avrebbe dovuto organizzare la mostra, sempre quella degli spam, e questa galleria non mi ha risposto. A un certo punto la mostra doveva partire a settembre, ad aprile ho ricevuto una risposta in cui la galleria mi diceva che il lavoro non era piaciuto. E questo per me è stato un duro colpo, perché naturalmente ci avevo messo tanto lavoro, e sentirmi dire che tutta la mia fatica non era servita a niente, ovviamente non è stata una cosa molto piacevole. Invece per me l'idea era molto buona, il materiale che avevo raccolto era ottimo e quindi non ero assolutamente d'accordo con il parere della galleria, per cui ho cominciato a mandare il materiale a tutti i concorsi e ho speso molti soldi naturalmente, perché spedire tutto il materiale ai vari concorsi che si tenevano in Spagna mi è costato tanto, però ho cominciato ad avere un ottimo ritorno, ho cominciato a ricevere dei premi, dei riconoscimenti e sono stata invitata a partecipare ad un festival che adesso purtroppo non si tiene più in Spagna, in cui venivano scelti 30 fotografi ai quali veniva data la possibilità di esibire le proprie fotografie in una specie di mostra mercato alla quale partecipavano anche esperti del settore ed anche editori. E il curatore di questa mostra è un museo che fa parte di una piccola università nel sud della Spagna e l'iniziativa mira a supportare i fotografi emergenti grazie ad un importo di 1.900 euro con i quali ogni fotografo deve organizzare la propria mostra e deve stampare il catalogo. E di questo catalogo devono essere stampate 1.000 copie. Ora, devo dire che 1.900 euro non sono proprio tantissimi, però in effetti la cosa utile di questa iniziativa è che il museo si occupa in prima persona di diffondere il catalogo, quindi lo spedisce a vari enti, a vari musei, per cui diciamo che come iniziativa è un'ottima iniziativa perché dà la possibilità ai fotografi emergenti di farsi conoscere. E per cui ho deciso di partecipare a questo evento e anche perché avevo molto materiale da mostrare e oltretutto avevo bisogno di utilizzare questo materiale a quel punto per fare un libro, per pubblicare un libro.
So I had a deadline, I had the story, I had the documents, and the challenge was to make the best object, the best book that could contain the story with all the layers that I wanted and with all the game, inviting everybody to play the game of fact and fiction. I considered it my first book because I was completely free. It was not like the previous one with Paula, that it has to include the text of the curator and all that. This one, it was paid by me, with no limitations and no boundaries and almost no previous experience in making a photo book. I was very lucky, again, because I could work with two very good friends that are actually based in Italy. I am sure you know Fabrica in Treviso. So Ramon Pezzarini is the art director of Colors magazine, and Laia Abril is a photo editor, is an associate photo editor there, and we're very good friends. So when I asked them, okay, I need a designer for the book, I said, okay, let's do it together. It was also the first photo book for them, and it was like a very dynamic and very funny teamwork, in which we were just changing and creating, and why don't we do that, and why don't we do the other. So it was completely free, and I learned a lot in this process.
E quindi a quel punto, partecipando a questa iniziativa, io avevo una data entro la quale finire il mio libro, il materiale che dovevo utilizzare e il supporto per utilizzarlo. E io lo considero il mio primo libro, anche se in effetti avevo già pubblicato quello su Paola, perché solo nella pubblicazione degli Afronauti non avevo nessun limite, avevo la completa libertà di fare quello che volevo. E diciamo che in questa occasione sono stata anche molto fortunata perché ho potuto lavorare con due ottimi amici che vivono e lavorano in Italia, e anche per loro è stato il primo fotolibro e insieme abbiamo formato un'ottima squadra, molto dinamica e molto creativa, che ha permesso appunto di ottenere come risultato questo libro.
So we were like changing things, for example there is no I really wanted to play the mystery, like nobody understanding at the beginning what it's about, and understanding the book like a movie that you discover. One of the things that I don't like about photo books, about classical photo books, is that you have the title with the name and the title and a small text that explains a little bit about the title, and then you have 10 pages of text that analyze the images, and I think this is very limiting, and that it's something that just happens in photography. If you go to a painting exhibition, there is not, before you see each painting, a text of someone who is giving the interpretation of the painting. Or if you go to the movies, there is not, at the beginning of the movie, a text saying this is this and this is that, and this is what the author wanted, and this is they just let you discover the story. So my intention was to follow the same structure with a book, that you discover slowly what it's about and you don't know everything from the beginning.
Quindi diciamo che con questa squadra dinamica abbiamo lavorato molto, abbiamo cambiato molto quello che era l'impostazione iniziale. E, la cosa che abbiamo voluto sottolineare è stato il mistero intorno a questo libro. Quello che non mi piace dei fotolibri è che generalmente sono fatti così: c'è un titolo, c'è una foto indicativa del contenuto del libro, e c'è un breve testo descrittivo e poi si apre il libro e ci sono 10 pagine di testo che spiegano e interpretano in qualche modo le foto che sono racchiuse nel libro. Io credo che questo non sia giusto. Del resto, se noi andiamo a vedere una mostra di quadri, non è che dobbiamo prima leggere un testo che ci interpreta i quadri che andiamo a vedere. La stessa cosa se andiamo a vedere un film al cinema, non è che prima dobbiamo leggere un libretto in cui ci spiegano che cosa il film vuole dire, in cui ci spingono ad interpretare le scene. Quindi la mia intenzione era quella di utilizzare la stessa struttura anche per il mio libro. Nessuna spiegazione scritta.
The edit was done between Laia and me, like how we play with how we discover the story. And the design, fantastic design, is done by Ramon Pezzarini. It was a big challenge because we had very many different kinds of documents. We had the pictures, but the pictures were not the most important part, even if they were. They didn't have to look like the most important part because it's not a photo book, it's a story told in images. So it's not that I wanted the images beautiful on a beautiful paper, very big, so that you could see the detail. It had to give the feeling that it's an archive, something found, something that happened in the 60s, and the quality is not, doesn't have to be necessarily good. I also had all these letters that I found on the internet. These are real letters that the ministers interchanged during the training and so on. So I just found the text and I used an old typewriter to type them again on an old paper and just create the document, the illusion of a real document. And by doing that, putting some balance, because if you just see this image, it's completely crazy. That makes no sense. Nobody would believe this is real. But if you put the document, then it puts some balance. So what I did with this book is actually putting in one object, that is a book, all that I have been experimenting in the years before. Like all I have been learning with how you can play with a document, with a text and with an image, how you can suggest things with photography, how you can play with fact and fiction. All the things that I had been discovering during this personal research for all these years, I could use them in this book because I was completely free.
Quindi l'edit è stata fatta da Laiani, il design da Pesarini e in effetti la mia intenzione era quella di non dare troppa importanza alle foto, nel senso che le foto non sono la parte più importante del libro, perché ripeto, questo non è un fotolibro, è una storia. Quindi bisogna dare attraverso le foto la sensazione che sia una storia vera avvenuta negli anni 60. Addirittura io ho inserito delle lettere che ho trovato su internet, naturalmente ho preso solo i testi e li ho riscritti con una macchina da scrivere, diciamo modello anni 60, in modo da ricreare questi testi antichi che abbiamo pubblicato nel libro. E in effetti nessuno crede che questa storia sia vera, però abbiamo cercato di dare la maggiore veridicità a tutto quanto, anche attraverso questi documenti che abbiamo ricreato, in modo da riuscire ad ottenere il mio scopo, cioè giocare con i testi, con le immagini, in modo tale da convincere gli altri che quello che sta riportando è la realtà.
So I also had the chance to use my drawings. That is something that, after all, I graduated in drawing, so like I want to use my drawings, and it's my book, so I can do it. So I also added all the sketches that I had been doing, and well, you see, the edit of the image is very different from the one you showed before. I also created vintage documents, like old archive, That are most of the time made with 50% old pictures, imagery from Africa in the 60s or 40s or 50s, and old archive I found of the NASA and all these weird experiments I had been researching before finding the story of the astronauts. So it's like Photoshop collage creating fake documents.
E ho avuto anche la possibilità naturalmente di inserire i miei disegni, anche perché il libro è il mio, quindi posso fare quello che voglio, e ho anche cercato di fare dei documenti vintage, alcuni tramite delle vecchie foto degli anni 40, anni 50 dell'Africa, altre prese da file NASA, da riviste appunto che parlavano della NASA, quindi abbiamo fatto un lavoro di Photoshop, abbiamo unito queste foto e abbiamo fatto delle foto vintage.
So there's different kinds of paper. This is because Ramon is such a good designer that he did an amazing research on types of paper and so on. For example, the paper I use for the drawings were originally in color. He said, we do it black and white. It's like, okay, we do black and white. And then we wanted, it could not be like just one page in straight, in normal paper, because then that would mean that I have a white page when I turn it, and that is not good. So we decided to use transparent paper, and it's actually the paper you use to wrap the mozzarella that we used, which is very cheap. And the ones for the documents is actually the cheapest paper we could buy, the cheapest one. Like the selection was made the cheapest one because it's made in Africa and it has to be humble and tactile, so it made no sense to use luxury materials.
E, io non sono una buona disegnatrice, comunque ho riportato i miei disegni su una carta particolare. I disegni all'inizio erano a colori, poi abbiamo deciso di renderli in bianco e nero e invece di usare la carta normale abbiamo deciso di riportare questi disegni su carta trasparente, perché sennò sarebbe rimasto il bordo bianco. Per quanto riguarda i documenti, diciamo, ricostruiti, i documenti antichi africani ricostruiti, li abbiamo stampati su una carta molto semplice, molto economica, perché naturalmente essendo antichi documenti africani non potevano certamente essere stampati su una carta di lusso.
So this is the use I gave to the most iconic image in the book, in the print, and in the whenever it's exhibited, it is like the main image. But in the book, it is really something that is cut and printed in the worst paper ever. So yes, it's like the back of maps. So I think it was a very good team, because Laia managed to just bring me out of the edit I already had been using for the series in online, and Ramon just had the skills and the experience to find very smart solutions.
Qui comunque vedete molte immagini iconiche, abbiamo giocato molto sulla carta di bassa qualità proprio per dare l'idea della veridicità della storia che stavamo raccontando. Il team col quale ho lavorato è stato un ottimo team, anche perché era formato da, ho avuto il supporto di due persone molto preparate e con molta esperienza, che hanno potuto trovare le migliori soluzioni per farmi ottenere il risultato che volevo.
So for example, the collage. They are in a different paper, they work like inserts in the book. So if you put the insert, you have a white page in the back. So to break this white page on the back, what we did is to cut it not evenly, like it's not symmetric. So one part is shorter than the other. And so we cut, we don't have this white part on the right. But this is like technical aspects of the book, maybe I don't need to bore you with that.
Per esempio, per quanto riguarda i collage, siccome i collage erano stampati su diversi tipi di carte ed erano inseriti, sono inseriti all'interno del libro come inserti veri e propri, sapete che quando inserite un qualcosa in un libro resta la pagina bianca dietro, quindi per evitare la pagina bianca abbiamo usato l'escamotage di mettere delle pagine asimmetriche in modo da evitare il bianco e da creare questo effetto, però questa è una tecnica molto specifica e non voglio annoiarvi su questo.
So, I was obviously very happy with the book, because I realized that it was the best object to tell a story. I mean, it's a funny story, it had many good things for me, because I learned a lot, but the fact of doing an object that is the best one you can make, according to me, to tell a story, was a very satisfactory thing to happen. And then all that happened after that was even more amazing, because many people agreed on the fact that it was a good book. It was selected by Joan Fontcuberta as, well, in the jury of the Deutsche Börse. So I was a finalist for the Deutsche Börse. So you can imagine, 6 months before, 1 year, 8 months before, I was crying because my gallery had just told me that it was a shitty project that had no future. And then I have Joan Fontcuberta calling me, telling me that I am a finalist for this amazing prize. So it has been a hell of a year.
E, diciamo che sono stata molto felice della pubblicazione di questo libro, anche perché ho capito che era la cosa migliore che io potessi usare per raccontare una storia. E fare un oggetto che si rivela essere il migliore oggetto che si potesse fare per raccontare una storia, naturalmente non può che creare una grossa soddisfazione. E a parte il fatto che molte persone mi dicono che è un buon libro, è stato anche selezionato per un premio molto importante. E immaginate come dovevo sentirmi se 8 mesi prima io stavo piangendo per il rifiuto da parte della galleria, e poi 8 mesi dopo ero stata insignita di un premio che per me è stata una grossa soddisfazione.
So I'm going to move on to the next project. I am sure you might have questions about the book. You really feel free to ask me whatever you want. I can give all the details. I can tell you how much it cost, how much I sold it, like everything you need to know. Feel free to ask me, because I learned a lot with this project, and I think it's a good thing that I share whatever I learned. So really, really feel free to ask me whatever you want. After I explain the next thing, at the end, if you want. We can leave like 20 minutes for your questions, but unless you have a very specific question now. Anybody has a question about the book? No, I forgot. But because I am, the books I have left, and they're not very, not many of them, I have them in London, and I don't go home. I mean, I haven't gone home for, I don't know, many months. So, yeah.
Mi dispiace di non avere copie con me, sono a casa a Londra, è un bel po' di tempo che non torno a casa, per cui non ho copie con me. Comunque aveva detto prima che se ci sono delle domande specifiche le potete fare adesso, se invece volete fare delle domande più generiche su quello che ha detto, è disponibile a rispondere alla fine dell'evento, anche perché siccome hai imparato molto dalla creazione e dalla produzione di questo libro, è giusto che anche voi possiate apprendere delle lezioni dalla sua esperienza.
So, yeah. No, I won't do a second edition of the book, not anytime soon, because it was, I mean, the book, it was completely crazy. I printed 1,000 copies of the book. I gave 350 to the university, and then I went to the Arles. And I was doing the portfolio review, so I gave one copy of the book to each of the 11 reviewers that I chose, and then they showed it to other people, and at some point the book arrived in hands of Martin Parr, who is a guru in the photo book. So I remember, and I think I have two big important moments in all this thing that happened to me, is when I found the story, that was like, wow, this is really good. And then the next year that I was in Arles having breakfast, and I was checking my email in the only free Wi-Fi spot there is, and I got I see Martin Parr in the inbox. He's like, Christine, I've heard very good things of your book. Can I get, where can I buy one? I say, no, I am in Arles until I need to go back to London. It's where all the books are. I say, where are you in Arles? I am Le Café de l'Ordon. And then 5 minutes later, I was having breakfast with Martin Parr, and he was like, bah, 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 and giving me a lot of advice. And then we went to see Jerry Badger, and that moment just changed completely my life, because my life, I don't know, well, yes, it changed my life, excuse obviously.
Me. Sorry.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Mi dispiace, ma non ho sentito molto, perché se non parla, cioè se parla verso di voi non la sento
okay,
bene.
Sorry. You want me to repeat?
Yes.
Okay.
Non lo so, c'è bisogno di tradurre quello che ha detto, oppure possiamo andare avanti? Perché se no me lo ripete un attimo.
Okay. It's okay? Okay.
Maybe if you have finished with your presentation, you can sit down here.
No, I haven't finished. But we can swap. You can. We can.
Yeah, because when you answer the questions, okay. I cannot hear you.
Okay. Now I'm going to talk to you.
Okay. Okay.
So I'm going to talk to you. Sorry. So after the book was published, I thought I would have 700 copies of the book for me forever. But then after what happened with Martin Parr, I started getting 100 emails a day of people who wanted to buy the book. And I was in Italy at my sister's house that is completely, it's beautiful, and I was on holidays. And I spent like 2 or 3 months going to the stationery, buying envelopes, sending everything. And I've been like 3 months just selling books as if I had a bookstore. And that is not my job. This is not what I want to do. And because it is a self-published book, I have to do it, because otherwise it doesn't make sense. So what I did is to, the PDF is free to download. You can get it from the university for free. And I did an app for iPad that is unlimited edition. You can download it as many times as you want. That is a very good translation of the book, and it was also a very good exercise. But I am not spending more months in my life just to make more objects, because, and I think also that 1,000 is a lot for a self-published book. If I had printed 50, but 1,000 is a lot. There is big publishing houses who do not even publish 1,000. So, sorry. Yeah.
Quindi
there has been 24 exhibitions this year. So yes, I have shown it twice a month in different places.
E quindi dopo la pubblicazione ed aver lasciato le copie all'università, mi erano rimaste circa 700 copie, e, mi trovavo in Italia in vacanza da mia sorella e continuavo a ricevere circa 100 mail al giorno di persone che volevano il mio libro. Quindi ho passato 2 o 3 mesi a spedire libri, a comprare buste, a spedire libri, andare all'ufficio postale, e devo dire che in effetti questo non è il mio lavoro, anche se essendo un libro autopubblicato purtroppo la spedizione toccava a me, e per cui ho deciso di non stampare più copie, perché appunto non devo dedicare la mia vita a spedire libri. C'è il PDF del libro su internet che è scaricabile gratuitamente. Abbiamo fatto anche un'app per iPad che è illimitata, quindi voi potete, se volete, avere accesso al mio libro e io non dovrò più passare il tempo negli uffici postali. E diciamo che il modo migliore per vedere il mio libro è quello di partecipare alle mie mostre. Quest'anno ce ne sono state 24, quindi diciamo do la possibilità a tutti di vedere il mio libro.
Sorry. So after the success of the Afronauts, a lot of people wanted to do a book with me, not because I think, just because I sell, and because my books are expensive. Let's be honest. It's not because they think I am genius. They really want to make a book because they can sell it, and that is another lesson that I learned very well this year. But still, I took advantage of it, obviously. So the second book I made, I was approached by Self-Publish Be Happy, which is a platform that maybe you know. It's a platform for self-published books, and they do this book club, and they produce, they actually become publishers themselves. They invite photographers to do a volume of their collection. And I was invited by Bruno Sechel to do a book.
Quindi dopo il successo di Afronauti, moltissimi hanno cominciato a contattarmi perché volevano pubblicare dei libri con me, volevano fare dei libri con me. Sinceramente penso che io non sia stata avvicinata perché mi considerassero un genio, ma semplicemente perché i miei libri vendono, quindi avevano interesse a vendere i libri che facevano con me. E, per quanto riguarda il mio secondo libro, sono stata avvicinata dalla Self Publish Be Happy, che mi ha invitata a fare un libro per loro e con loro.
So I decided to take advantage, not because I wanted to make any money. If any of you wants to know, you don't make money with books. I didn't make any money with the Afronauts. I make money selling prints, but the book is really not a good way of getting rich. But I think it's a very good and interesting platform to show your work, especially for me because I work with sequences and I work with stories. So it's the most similar you can get to a movie because you turn the pages and there is episodes and so on. So when I was showing the Afronauts at the very beginning, even before Arles, I spent some time in New York having meetings and showing the book. And I thought, okay, I am in New York, I am a photographer. I came back to what I used to do when I was a photojournalist, like I need to do something in New York. And New York is the capital for street photography. There is a lot of street photographers and a lot of photographers who have become famous in New York. So with the Afronauts, maybe I gave my version of what a documentary work should be in my ideal world full of unicorns and rainbows. I wanted to give how, for me, in this ideal world, street photography would be. And street photography has things that make it a very respected genre in photography. You cannot modify street, you cannot stage street photography. What is the sense if you stage street photography? They look exactly the same, but they have not this value of this really happened. But it's very difficult to recognize and to decide whether it was staged or not. Maybe it's enough.
Naturalmente voglio dire che con la pubblicazione dei libri io non avevo nessuna volontà di fare soldi, anche perché non si guadagna con i libri. Io al massimo guadagno con la vendita delle mie stampe, però posso dire che i libri sono una buona piattaforma di lancio per far capire agli altri che cosa si vuole dire e come si lavora. E quando è uscito Gli Afronauti mi trovavo a New York per una serie di incontri per presentare il libro e a un certo punto mi sono detta: io sono una fotografa e mi trovo a New York e visto che sono a New York devo fare qualcosa da fotografa, e anche perché dobbiamo dire che New York è la città dei fotografi di strada. E con il libro Afronauti io sono riuscita a fare quello che volevo fare, sono riuscita a dare un'idea di quello che io intendo per fotografia di strada, perché in effetti non è facile distinguere la fotografia di strada. Quando si vede una fotografia non è facile capire se questa fotografia è stata preparata oppure se è effettivamente una fotografia di strada.
So what I decided to do just for fun, I didn't know this would become into a book, just to spend the days I was in New York, is to document the New York I wanted to see, not the New York there is, but what I expect from New York. And one of my favorite movies is West Side Story. I've watched this movie many, many times, and I love how they just, I love musicals in general, because they are talking and then they start singing, and I think that is amazing, and I wish it could happen like that in real life. It doesn't. So I decided to tell the story, to find West Side Story, again in New York, with the language of street photography. So these are like my sort of notebook, sort of. So I took screenshots of the movie and made translations and found the real version of what is in the movie. This is just to explain how I worked. And I was actually asking people, can you do that? Mixing real street photography with stage photography.
Quindi ho deciso, mentre mi trovavo a New York, per divertimento, quindi per passare il tempo, visto che ero lì, di documentare New York, però di documentare la New York che io volevo vedere. E uno dei miei film preferiti è sempre stato West Side Story, sia perché mi piacciono i musical, sia perché la storia di West Side Story è una storia molto bella che sicuramente non avviene mai nella realtà. Per cui ho cercato la vera West Side Story a New York con il linguaggio del fotografo di strada e ho preso delle immagini del film e ho cercato di ricreare le immagini, le stesse immagini del film, però nella New York reale, unendo quindi la fotografia di strada alla fotografia di studio.
So yes, these are some of the examples that I didn't use in the book in the end, but you get to see how I worked. And I'm going to show you the Sorry, the PDF.
Quindi alcuni degli esempi che ha mostrato naturalmente sono nel libro. Adesso mostrerà il PDF.
So the movie starts with 7 minutes of changing colors and the credits. I don't know if you watch the movie. I really recommend this movie. It's fantastic. And it starts. It's really literally 7 minutes of music and changing colors. That is something really hard to do now. I mean, nobody would start a movie like that. So the book starts with 3 pages of changing colors. And then there is a zenithal view of New York.
E il film comincia con 7 minuti di colori che cambiano. Io non so se avete mai visto il film, comunque effettivamente sono proprio 7 minuti di musica e colori che cambiano. Credo che oggi nessuno si azzarderebbe a fare tanto. Comunque anche il libro comincia con pagine di colori che cambiano. Poi abbiamo un'immagine di New York.
So sometimes I work with the idea that is behind each of the scenes. Sometimes I do literal translation of what is really on the movie. So it starts with an introduction of the two gangs, the Jets and the Sharks. Sorry. And this is like images that express that.
E a volte lavoro soltanto con le mie idee di quello che io vedo nella New York di West Side Story. Altre volte invece traduco letteralmente quello che è nel film in scene di vita reale di New York.
And other things that are interesting in street photography is that there is always something, some tension in the. There is always a reason why you take this picture of a street. You can call it the punctum or whatever, but there is always something striking. So what I did is just highlighting and manipulating this point that is striking. For example, this one is the image I use to present the Jets, that are the Irish gang or Polish gang. And I just took the picture of this guy who had a very funny red hair. And what I did is to copy and paste, and they have the same hair. But it is something that you don't realize at the beginning. You just think that there's something weird. And it just manipulating for fun street photography to see how far you can go and to see where is the limit and how you can identify and decide if it's true or if it's not, if it has a value as a street photography document or if it doesn't.
E un'altra cosa molto interessante secondo me nella fotografia di strada è che c'è sempre una ragione per fare una foto di strada e queste foto hanno cercato di sottolineare, di manipolare il motivo per cui queste foto venivano fatte. Per esempio la foto di questi ragazzi con questi strani capelli rossi, e io che cosa ho fatto? Ho fatto una foto a questi ragazzi e poi ho fatto un taglia e incolla e ho messo i capelli originali del film, quindi ho cercato di manipolare questa foto di strada e per cercare di capire dove si può arrivare con la manipolazione delle foto e con la manipolazione soprattutto delle idee che ci sono dietro le foto.
So I'm going to go quickly, just highlighting some of them. This is a literal translation, as you saw previously. Also, I play with the concept again. It is the Jets against the Sharks in West Side Story. So the Jets is also a football team in New York. It's the main football team. But doing this very simple research I normally do, I found that there is also a Sharks football team. And it's a women's football team in Brooklyn. So I called them and asked them if they would be ready to wear the uniforms and have a photo shooting in Brooklyn. So this is the Sharks. And in the book, they are all double spreads, and this is like a double spread. And this image comes with a playing card of the Jets. So it's the Jets and the Sharks, playing again with the concepts, with the object and the idea of the Jets and the Sharks in a very simple way.
E io gioco anche con i concetti, riferendomi alle due bande rivali nel film, ho scoperto che in effetti hanno lo stesso nome di due squadre di football, una delle due è una squadra femminile, quindi ho contattato questa squadra di football femminile, che è quella nella foto, le ho contattate e ho fatto questa fotografia diciamo richiamandomi alle squadre rivali, alle bande rivali del film. Quindi io gioco con i concetti, gioco con le idee e questi sono i risultati.
So I'm going to go quickly. This, for example, is three guys coming to me, and I just ask them to stop and do that again, dancing. So it's adapting reality to what I need from reality. And it is something that you're not supposed to do if you're a photojournalist, but and you're not supposed to do if you're a street photographer, but I am none of these. So I can do it.
Quindi molto velocemente, questa è una foto di tre ragazzini che stavano venendo verso di me, a un certo punto gli ho chiesto di fermarsi per fare questa foto, quindi io cerco anche di adattare la realtà quando scatto delle fotografie.
The closest I could find to dancing in the street was people with skateboards. So what I did is taking pictures of skateboarders and erase the skateboard so they start dancing.
Quindi per riproporre i balletti per strada del film ho potuto soltanto utilizzare dei ragazzi sullo skateboard, perché è l'unica cosa che per strada può ricordare più o meno i balletti di un musical.
So this is for example my version of the song Maria that is very famous.
Questa è la mia immagine della Madonna.
This is my version of I like to live in America.
Questa è la mia immagine di vorrei I like to be in America, la canzone di
Some
di
images
Story.
When there is a killing for example, so it I work with symbols and images that suggest more than actually explain what it's about.
Questa è un'immagine del gelo, io preferisco utilizzare i simboli più che spiegare bene quello
It
che
is
intendo.
A broken glass. And again, I had a problem with the ending. I just had like 5 days to shoot this story in New York. I started it. I had the idea and I said, okay, I will finish it whenever I come back to New York. But then Bruno contacted me and I decided to go back to New York because they gave me a deadline again. So I was just 1 week in New York and I had to do everything, not everything, but a lot of things. And I had to stage a lot of pictures. And I had just like 24 hours left before I was coming back to London. And I still hadn't find anything that that I could use as the ending of the story. If you know the end of the story, West Side Story is like a new version of Romeo and Juliet. And there is a problem of communication, they don't know where they are, and in the end, at the very end of the story and of the movie, they finally find each other, and that is the moment where he is killed. So it was very difficult for me, how can I do that? I mean, I cannot ask my friends to play that role, because you will see that they are not professional actors, and it could ruin the whole thing. So I was lucky. That is what happened again. And I was just walking the streets in it was Madison Avenue, and I saw these two women that were really, really drunk, but completely drunk, and I started following them. And I followed them for a couple of hours, and after some time, they stopped, they kissed, and she fell. So this is something that really happened, but it's the most fictional and most strong part of the story, but it really happened in front of me. So it is a way of forcing reality to become what you want. And again, follow people. Just follow until you get it. And then it's the end.
Quindi, quindi per concludere, comunque si ripresentava sempre il problema del tempo. Io avevo soltanto 5 giorni da passare a New York, avevo l'idea, avevo il materiale e ho pensato nel caso la prossima volta che torno a New York finisco, però Bruno mi ha chiamato e mi ha dato una scadenza, per cui a un certo punto mi sono trovata con il problema della fine, non avevo la fine per il mio libro. E voi sapete che West Side Story è una sorta di moderno Romeo e Giulietta e ci sono problemi di comunicazione, problemi di comprensione, alla fine i due protagonisti si ritrovano, però si ritrovano nel momento in cui lui viene ucciso, quindi come potevo finire il mio libro? A questo punto sono stata di nuovo fortunata perché passeggiavo a Madison Avenue e ho visto queste due donne completamente ubriache, le ho seguite per circa un paio d'ore, ho fatto delle foto, a un certo punto queste donne si sono fermate, si sono baciate, una delle due è caduta, quindi avevo trovato la fine per il mio libro, quindi anche ancora una volta la realtà era riuscita a diventare quello che io volevo diventasse.
So the book was sold out on pre-sale. And it was not, I mean, what I wanted with doing the new book is to just turn the page and having, I had so many people wanting to get the Afronauts. I just wanted to do a new book, so there is a new book, just leave me alone. But the effect was the opposite, because everybody would buy the book, and I didn't even have, I think, just one review. Not many people know about this book, because just a lot of people just bought it because it was like a sort of investment. And it is...
Anche questo libro è stato venduto, ma è stato venduto soprattutto, è stato comprato soprattutto da persone che sapevano che avevo pubblicato quest'altro libro dopo gli Afronauti e l'avevano comprato soprattutto come investimento.
Ok, so the title is Self-Published Be Happy Photo Book Club Volume 3. But... The series is called Strap Fingers and Whistle. That is the title of the book. Yes, but it is expensive now. It is, I think.
Per il momento è troppo costoso.
Yes, because then it's well. I will explain you the story if you want. And it's, I'm being recorded, so I cannot tell what happened. But it was £40, I think. That is the price of the book. But it was sold out, so I know Bruno now is selling them for maybe £200 or something like that. And the Afronauts, I don't know. There is crazy people selling it for 4,000, but I think you can buy it for 1,500 or something like that. But it's still crazy. I wouldn't buy it.
Allora, diceva che il secondo libro è stato venduto, è stato stravenduto all'inizio per 40 sterline, adesso viene venduto a circa 200 sterline. Gli Afronauti adesso viene venduto a circa 400 sterline e diceva che secondo lei, cioè lei non lo compra 4.000 sterline, ma diceva che lei non lo comprerebbe mai a questo prezzo.
So, any more questions about... On the West Side Story, it has been shown in a festival in northern Spain, Get Your Photo, and also in Unseen Festival. Italy, well, yes, why not? It is just 28 images, and it's like a big, big stripe, just put all together, like a big line of images. And yes, it was also in Unseen, it's a festival in Amsterdam, and a hotel in New York bought the whole series in the Bowery. So you can see it in New York in a hotel. Metropole or something like that? I don't know. It's in the Bowery, and it's a new hotel. It will be. They will open, I think, next year. So, when I was doing the Afronauts, and when the gallery told me that the Afronauts was not good, also I had a problem with my boyfriend. So I decided to run away. And the place you run away is China. And I went to China just because of that, because it's far away and I could cut with everything and start over again. I was even planning to move there, but then I realized I don't like the food. So I came back to London. But I spent like 3 months in China, most of the time living with Chinese families. And it was a very strong experience and like a reset, a very, very intense one. So I had no real story, no real interest in doing anything, but just enjoying photography again and taking pictures of things that were attractive to me. Obviously, if you are in China, the first conclusion you come up with is that it is formally a communist country, but in fact it is not. So it's not that I am an expert in China, that is the only conclusion I got. Maybe you want to translate that.
Yes, maybe. Quindi dopo che gli Afronauti era stato rifiutato dalla galleria e ho avuto anche un problema personale con il mio ragazzo, quindi ho deciso di scappare. Qual è il posto migliore per scappare? Sicuramente la Cina. Per cui ho deciso di andare in Cina e dopo aver vissuto 3 mesi in Cina e in varie famiglie cinesi ho deciso che non mi piaceva il cibo, quindi sono tornata a Londra. Diciamo che la mia permanenza in Cina non era basata su nessun interesse specifico, quindi non mi interessava fare niente, mi volevo soltanto riposare, rilassare e godere della fotografia che in effetti era la mia passione principale. E vivendo in Cina mi sono resa conto di una cosa principale, che formalmente la Cina è comunista, ma in effetti in sostanza non lo è.
I was shooting the Afronauts in this time too, so I was doing this and the Afronauts. So after the Afronauts, after the self-published Be Happy, there was more people wanting to do books with me. So as I had no time to really produce new work, I decided, okay, I'm gonna do something with what I have. And I wanted to give a chance to whatever I had in China, produced in China, but as I had no structure and no idea and no story behind, it was very hard for me. I even tried to do multimedia, but I am not very happy with. But after all, I decided, okay, I need to do a book. Let's do a book about China. If you think book and China, the first thing that comes to your mind is this. The Little Red Book. So what I did is to adapt The Little Red Book to what I think is China for me. And I did that at the beginning just with Tippex, erasing and whiting out the parts of communism that were not accurate anymore. Yes, maybe you want to translate.
Okay. Nel periodo in cui mi trovavo in Cina stavo anche ancora lavorando sugli Afronauti e naturalmente dopo la pubblicazione degli Afronauti, come ho detto prima, molti hanno cominciato a chiedere di fare un libro con me. In effetti avevo molto materiale che avevo prodotto in Cina e ho cercato con questo materiale di fare anche un libro multimediale, del cui risultato non sono molto soddisfatta, e per cui ho pensato di fare un libro vero e proprio sulla Cina. Ora, quando si associa l'idea lì libro e Cina, che cosa ci viene in mente? Il libretto rosso. Quindi ho preso il libretto rosso, ho preso il mio materiale e ho cominciato a utilizzare anche il bianchetto per adattare il materiale che avevo al lavoro che volevo fare.
So the Bible of Communism works as a funny vision about China that has a lot to do with the state of mind that I was in, and it is just whiting out all the pages, turning the message into something that I can support, and that is my opinion rather than Chairman Mao's. And the book can be understood as a political statement, because it is in a way, but not a very deep one, because I am not an expert in China again. But it can also be understood as I think actually it is one of my most personal work, because I am talking about the failure of an utopia. About believing in something that doesn't exist. It has a lot to do with my personal moment. So it can be understood as a political statement, but also as a private diary.
In effetti io ho rivisto la Bibbia del comunismo dando la mia visione buffa della Cina, e naturalmente soltanto la mia opinione. Questo libro può essere visto come un'affermazione politica, cosa che poi in effetti è, perché avendo scoperto che la Cina non era comunista mi è crollata un'utopia. In effetti io ho cercato anche di fare non solo appunto un libro che deve essere un'affermazione politica, ma anche un libro personale, perché naturalmente in questo libro c'è tutta la mia opinione personale sulla Cina.
So the book was launched in Parifoto 10 days ago, but we had a problem. I have this curse with the books. We had a problem with the printing. I am not very happy with how the images are printed. So, and we changed a few things. It's a quite complicated book to make because the images are like inserts, and we changed something that made the book even more complicated to print, and everything was done in a rush. So in the end, I just had 50 books available in Paris, and you can imagine a lot of people, all the ones who like the story or like my work, and all the ones who want to buy 20 just because it's an investment, they were not very happy. So again, I spent many hours telling people there is no more books, which is like my curse. So there will be more books. The run is 1,700. And I hopefully they will be ready for Christmas. So this is like the first test. If you can pass it around so everybody can see it, thank you. And it is a facsimile edition of the Little Red Book by Mao, adapted to what I think is China, and with my images that work as a, like the new text works as a caption for the images. Again, playing with the dynamic there is between an image and a text.
E in effetti il libro è stato stampato da poco, c'è stato qualche problema con la stampa, infatti a me non piace molto la qualità delle foto, non mi piace come sono state stampate. Comunque dobbiamo dire che è un lavoro che è stato fatto abbastanza di fretta. Ultimamente ero a Parigi, avevo soltanto 50 libri disponibili e c'erano molte persone che mi chiedevano di comprare delle copie, anche perché, come ho detto, c'erano anche persone che volevano comprare più copie come investimento. E io ho dovuto passare moltissimo tempo a spiegare che non avevo più libri a disposizione, quindi questa è quasi una maledizione per me, devo sempre essere costretta a spiegare che non ho più libri. Comunque dovrebbero uscire altre 700 copie forse per Natale. E come potete vedere è un facsimile del libretto rosso di Mao in cui le mie foto diventano il nuovo testo di questo libretto rosso di Mao, sempre giocando con i concetti come sono abituata a fare.
So I had to come back to China and I was there this August because I didn't have enough images for all the pages and I was there with a like a mission. I need an African in China. I need like I had like the list of pages that I needed to illustrate. And spent 2 weeks or 3 weeks in China just getting the images I needed.
E poi sono stata costretta a tornare in Cina ad agosto perché non mi bastavano le foto, quindi avevo bisogno di fare qualche foto in più, per cui ho passato altre 2-3 settimane in Cina soltanto per fare fotografie che mi servivano per questo libro.
So I hope you all have the chance to have a look at the book.
Spero che abbiate la possibilità di vederlo questo libro.
Because it's like 440 pages in total, 80 images, 80 images, 78 images, but then there is one image every 8 pages with no image, just text. So it is a small and big book. It's very small, but.
Possiamo dire che è un piccolo grande libro, sono 440 pagine con 80 foto e circa 8 pagine di testi.
Why you're asking why I decided to go back to China? Because well, the Afronauts, I never had the intention to go to Africa. It was like a condition, I don't want to go to Africa because I don't want to it's not about Africa. Well, it is, it's about me. In this one, I was in China. I was running away from something else and I was in China. It's working the other way around. In one, I have a story and I create the images, and in this one, I had the images and I create the structure or the story. So.
In effetti è stato il contrario, mentre in Africa è andata perché aveva già creato la storia, in Cina ci si è trovata per caso, quindi si è trovata le foto per caso, non aveva creato nessuna storia prima.
So, yes, I think I'm gonna move on to the next one. I hope you just check the book. Yes. There was no reason to go to China. Yeah, I mean. Yes, I mean, I think the book is I see it and it is a very good diary of what happened to me in China. So in terms of that, it is a good project for me, but maybe I am the only one who understands it is a good diary. So I don't know. I don't know how the book is going to work. I know it's for me it makes sense and I can turn the page.
E in effetti più che un libro è un diario di quello che mi è successo in Cina, però è un diario che posso capire solo io. Sicuramente non so come andrà, però posso dire che è un diario di quello che ho vissuto in Cina.
So Well, this is the books. It's, I'm not sure if you see the last page. Yes, this is the last page of the book. One must learn not only from books.
So. Questa è l'ultima pagina del libro, bisogna imparare non soltanto dai libri.
So, how much time do we have left? 20 minutes, right?
Yes.
Okay. So, I'm going to jump to the last thing I've done that is pretty new, and I'm going to do that very quick so we have time for questions.
Adesso vi parlerò del mio ultimo lavoro, che è una cosa molto nuova, quindi sarò molto breve, poi eventualmente ci sarà spazio per qualche domanda.
So this was produced 10 days ago. I finished that. I was invited to Lagos Photo Festival in Nigeria, and so obviously I was going to Africa, and I was very excited about going to Africa, but I am aware that I cannot do work about Africa because nothing really changed. I didn't become an expert in Africa, and I'm not African again. So I don't think I am legitimate to talk about Africa. Again, I need to find a reason why me is saying something about Africa. And when I did the Afronauts, I received a lot of emails of people sending me references of books that I should absolutely read. Like, you're gonna like this story, you're gonna love this one, you're gonna love this one. So I have a very long list of books to read about Africa. And one of them is called My Life in the Bush of Ghosts. I read this one, and it's by a Nigerian author called Amos Tutuola. So maybe you want to...
What's the title of the book?
My Life in the Bush of Ghosts.
Yes, you can go on.
Okay, so I spent in Nigeria 3 weeks attending the festival, and then I gave myself 2 weeks to do a project. The first week when I was going to openings in the festival in Lagos, they brought us to this area of Lagos that is called Makoko, and is if you type Lagos in Google, you get images of Makoko because it is very attractive. It is a very poor neighborhood, a very dangerous one, but it is a floating neighborhood. And it is really one of the most dirty and disgusting places I've been in my life. They have, you just, you know, you're in a canoe and you literally row in shit. It's like that. So I was with other photographers as well, especially with photographers from big agencies that were also invited to the festival. And I could see how we were in this canoe looking at Makoko as tourists, and they would just, they didn't dare to take the picture, but they need to take the picture. So they want to just take the beautiful picture of this terrible situation. And I just could see, like, wow. Maybe I hadn't been exposed to that for a long time, and I was like, wow, this is incredible. So I decided to do something about the neighborhood. You okay, or I can continue?
No, I can translate. E 10 giorni fa sono stata invitata in Nigeria al Lagos Photo Festival e naturalmente sono andata in Africa, e, anche se continuo a ribadire che io non posso fare nessun lavoro sull'Africa perché non la conosco assolutamente, anche se ho ricevuto tante mail in cui mi si consigliavano dei libri sull'Africa. Uno che ho letto in particolare è stato My Life in the Bush of Ghosts di Amos Tutuola, e per cercare appunto di capire l'Africa, ma ripeto, io l'Africa non la conosco proprio, non la capisco proprio. Comunque ho passato 2 settimane in Nigeria per il festival e 2 settimane a lavorare sul progetto di cui vi parlerò subito. E all'apertura del festival siamo andati in un posto che si chiama Makoko, e se voi digitate su Google Nigeria potete vedere delle immagini di Makoko. È un posto molto povero, molto pericoloso, ed è il posto più disgustoso e più sporco nel quale io sia stata nella mia vita. è un villaggio galleggiante, e mi trovavo in questa zona con altri fotografi di grandi agenzie che erano stati invitati per lo stesso festival, e questi fotografi facevano finta di fare i turisti, anche se morivano dalla voglia di scattare fotografie, ma non hanno fatto neanche una foto, non hanno osato fare una fotografia. Invece io mi sono detta che avrei dovuto fare qualcosa per questo posto.
So the story of my life in the bush of goats is it was written in the 60s again in Africa, and it was written in English by a Nigerian, and if you read it, you have the feeling that it is like a child telling a story. You know, when they repeat themselves and they start really, really, when you read it, you have the feeling that it's a five-year-old telling a story. And it is a story of this five-year-old kid. His village is attacked by soldiers and he runs away. He is so young that he doesn't know what is good and what is bad. And he enters a forbidden place that is called the bush. It's a mythological place for Yoruba mythology. And it's a space, a virtual space, that corresponds to a real space, that is the jungle. And it is done by religion to prevent people to get into the jungle. So it's a scary place, you don't go in. So mythology is in charge of preventing that with these sorts of stories. So he doesn't know what is good and what is bad, and he gets into the bush. And he stays in the bush for 30 years. And the bush is full of ghosts, all sorts of ghosts. It's a very funny story, very sad, very disgusting, because it's very literal the way it's always full of shit and insects and just like a kid would tell a story. Very funny one. So because of that feeling that I had when I entered Makoko, I immediately realized that Makoko could work as a metaphor of the bush. Because I was not allowed in, I need to go with guides. The rules that operate inside this area are completely crazy. There are scary people with strange powers, and it is very easy to translate what the bush is to this part of Lagos, and that is what I did. I told the story of this book by Amos Tutuola in Makoko, staging everything and with the images that you're gonna see.
Vi ho nominato questo libro che ho letto sull'Africa, My Life in the Bush of Ghosts, che in effetti parla di un bambino che racconta una storia e racconta del suo villaggio che viene attaccato da alcuni soldati, e lui scappa e va a finire in questo bush che è una zona tabù, diciamo, è una zona che si trova al limite della giungla, è un posto spaventoso che costituisce, diciamo, il limite che non si può oltrepassare, e siccome questo bambino non sa bene che cos'è il bene e che cos'è il male, si rifugia in questo bush per cercare di capirlo, e vive in questo bush per circa 30 anni. Questo bush è un posto molto strano, pieno di fantasmi, pieno di cose strane, molto disgustoso, e diciamo che entrare a Makoko mi ha dato la sensazione di entrare in questo bush, e quindi secondo me poteva essere il posto giusto per raccontare la storia di questo romanzo che io avevo letto. Quindi ho scattato delle fotografie a Makoko e ho rappresentato questa gente inquietante che abita questo posto, gente con poteri strani, quindi ho trovato, diciamo, l'identificazione di questo bush in una zona reale di Laos.
So yes, again, it is adapting reality to what I need. If I find it, okay. If I cannot find it, I make it up. The story and the book is not very well known, so it is hard to understand. And now I still have to edit. There's many images here. But you get to see more or less how I worked, trying to find scary things around, trying to find ghosts. Sometimes I find them. And it's actually like, and also I wanted to really document Makoko, what is happening, but with this filter of scary and spooky opinion that I was adding to the place.
E quindi anche in questo caso ho cercato di adattare la realtà ai miei bisogni. Ho cercato all'interno di Makoko delle cose spaventose, delle cose inquietanti, dei fantasmi che a volte ho anche trovato, e ho cercato attraverso queste foto di documentare la realtà di Makoko, ma sempre secondo i miei bisogni, secondo quello che io volevo documentare.
So I brought to Nigeria because I wanted to tell that story. It was Halloween in London, so I went to a shop in Halloween and I bought a lot of insects and spider web and everything. And I was really crossing fingers for the customs not to stop me, because it was I had not many clothes, but I had a 2-meter snake and lots of cockroaches and flies. So yes, again, I work with sketches that were ready that I was doing while I was working reading the book, and I just had to go to the place, gain access, ask the king of Makoko to allow me to work there, and it was all done in 3 days.
Prima di tornare in Nigeria, era periodo di Halloween a Londra, quindi ho comprato un sacco di cose spaventose e ripugnanti. Ho comprato degli insetti, ho comprato degli scarafaggi e li ho portati in Nigeria sperando che la dogana non mi fermassero, anche perché avevo 2 grossi serpenti finti nella valigia. E ho dovuto chiedere al, diciamo, re di Makoko di farmi entrare nel villaggio, e in pochi giorni ho fatto questo lavoro.
So I'm going to show the images. They're not even edited. It's just like a selection of 80, and maybe stop in the ones that need some explanation.
Vi mostro delle immagini, naturalmente una selezione di immagini, perché in tutto sono 80. Comunque fermatevi se avete bisogno di qualche spiegazione.
So this will be a book for next year.
Opera sarà finita per l'anno prossimo.
Con un editore. I don't want to self-publish again. It's too much pressure. No, I mean, what I like is taking pictures and building. I mean, for me, what I enjoy doing is taking the pictures and doing the dummy. That's what I love doing. Then I give the dummy to whoever wants to print it, as long as I can. Maybe one day my luck turns and I need to self-publish again. But for the moment, I just give the dummy and it's like, do the same, 1,000. And that's it.
E per il momento mi piace soltanto fare le foto, metterle insieme e darle a un editore. Può darsi che in futuro la mia vita cambierà e dovrò riprendere con le autopubblicazioni, però per il momento faccio questo, raccolgo le foto, le do all'editore e basta.
So yes, if you have any questions, I will keep on showing the images. Yes. It is digital because I can use analog too. Some projects are made with analog. When I was doing more documentary, I used to work on Rolleiflex, But many pictures I take when I was on assignment for Red Cross and things like that, and I need to use a digital camera. So yes, it's not really important, really. I know all the photographers say that. But really, for me, it is not very important. It's as long as I can work, it's fine. And I use a 50mm lens for everything I shoot, and a Canon EOS 1DS Mark III or something like that. Yes, I cut it. I crop and add the white borders. Yes, no, but the one with the iPhone, I just took the picture with the iPhone and then I came the next day to take it with a big camera.
Ok, quindi dice che per lei la macchina fotografica non è importantissima, al momento usa macchine digitali, in passato usava una Rolleiflex, comunque non è molto importante, usa una lente da 15 mm e è stata chiesta in maniera specifica come mai. Era stata fatta la foto con l'iPhone, poi il giorno dopo è tornata e l'ha rifatta con una macchina digitale.
The snake. It floats. So this will be much better when it is edited.
Questo sarà migliore quando verrà pubblicato, naturalmente.
But it is funny how you actually in a very dangerous environment that you would never dare to get on your own, you get to people to do that. I like the moment when this happens, that it's closer to a performance than to photography, because I actually create something and document it. But I need to create that reality. And then I work like a photojournalist, because I don't work like a fashion photographer at all. It's not that I measure the light. No, I create this reality that I need. I ask this guy, wait for the light maybe that I like. Ask this guy to dance with this piece of clothes that I bought the day before. And then I just like click, click, click. And then we move to the next thing. Because it's like if something had really happened in front of me, and I am a photojournalist.
È strano appunto vedere come la gente collabori in questi ambienti pericolosi, ma questa è la cosa che mi piace di più dell'essere un fotogiornalista, perché io non lavoro in uno studio, non devo organizzare la scena, non devo organizzare la luce, io semplicemente chiedo alle persone di partecipare alle mie foto e loro lo fanno.
And if you know what you're looking for, then you start seeing ghosts everywhere.
Vedete che ci sono fantasmi dappertutto.
I didn't ask him to sing. He was so scared of seeing me. I think it was the first white person he saw. He was rowing his canoe and he was just and he jumped out of the boat and
io non
it was
avevo
so
chiesto
sad.
A questo bambino di annegare, semplicemente era così spaventato dal vedermi che ha cominciato a
I am the ghost for them. Yeah. Yeah, white and ghost. And it's funny because in I spent there, I don't know, 4 or 5 days preparing and shooting, and all the kids, and that's a lot of kids, around this area, they shout all the time. I mean, it is like the soundtrack that I hear. You have to go in a boat, so it's not that they can follow you, but you go through the houses and there's always a lot of kids in the houses, and they start screaming, yelling at me, Yavo, Yavo, and Yavo means white. And I was like, I know, but imagine, and I was telling the people who were helping me, the fixer and friends, like, imagine if in Chelsea, in London, there is some African, and everybody's like, black, black. It's the same. So, yes, not very comfortable.
E nei 4-5 giorni di preparazione di questo lavoro, tutti i bambini del villaggio, e sono tanti i bambini in quel villaggio, hanno continuato a gridare tutto il tempo. Ogni volta che passavo vicino alle loro case, gridavano nella loro lingua, bianca, bianca. E dicevo con i miei collaboratori, immaginate se a Chelsea, a Londra, ogni volta che passa un africano, tutti i bambini gridassero nero, nero, sarebbe una cosa paradossale.
So, this is one technique that I am using lately. It has no manipulation on Photoshop or anything like that. It's just with a mirror. I carry with me a mirror, and it is an idea I have. I'm going to show it very quickly. This one. This summer I was invited to New Zealand for a conference, and I had, I mean, normally I try to find stupid ideas where I can start to work. And one of these stupid ideas that came to me to my mind is that in New Zealand is actually the antipodes of Spain. If you dig a hole from Spain, you arrive in New Zealand. So people walk upside down. So as people walk upside down, I brought a mirror to New Zealand. And these are like some of the images I took. Just putting, if this is a camera, you put the image, the mirror like this, stick to the lens or like this, and then you reflect and you create this strange dimensions, but there's no Photoshop manipulation.
E questo è un trucco che io uso, non è assolutamente una manipolazione di Photoshop, io sono semplicemente uno specchio. Questa è stata una mia idea che mi è venuta l'anno scorso in Nuova Zelanda. Sono stata invitata la scorsa estate appunto in Nuova Zelanda e ho avuto questa idea stupida. Ho pensato che la Nuova Zelanda è gli antipodi della Spagna, quindi vuol dire che la gente cammina a testa in giù. Per cui ho preso uno specchio, l'ho messo contro la lente in un certo modo e ho ottenuto questo risultato.
And that's it. So also it was because I think I don't like landscape photography. I think it is super boring, and the photograph of a landscape is never as good as the landscape itself. So I wanted to force people to re-understand landscape by creating strange landscape, but just by adding one mirror to the already to the process that already includes a mirror. So just add one mirror and it makes sense conceptually because they walk upside down and et cetera, et cetera. So it's like very simple associations that in the end produce like what I think could be more interesting to use photography for. And that is it, I think.
E non mi piace la foto, non mi piacciono le foto dei paesaggi, quindi per forzare la gente a ricomprendere il paesaggio creo questi paesaggi strani con una semplice associazione che mi permette di produrre effetti molto più interessanti.
And this of course has to be edited and I don't know what it will become. It was just fun to do it.
Anche questo sarà pubblicato, non so come.
So, any questions?
Domande?
Speak a little louder. Sia i mushrooms che nel libro Stira Conversa Story, tu che utilizzi molto il linguaggio cinematografico, quindi parli di movie, fiction, sequenze filmiche. Mi chiedo se hai un legame più forte con una, oppure utilizzi molto la scenografia. Mi chiedo se hai un legame più forte con il film anche con la storia della fotografia.
I think I am much more interested in cinema than in photography, as products. I don't go to many photography exhibitions. I don't like that much photography exhibitions, but I go to the movies 2 or 3 times a week. I think it is very inspiring. And I think photography has to develop more before it becomes something that I am interested in. And it's maybe bad to say it because there is very interesting work, but what inspires me is never other photographers' work. It is movies, movies or books. So I take all my inspiration from that. There are many. I love Michael Gondry. I love Blade Runner is a reference. I love Wes Anderson. The humor of Wes Anderson is genius, even if the movies are not masterpieces. I love the Coen brothers. I love Woody Allen. I love Aronofsky. Many. I like all the movies because at the end what I do is to see the structure of the movie rather than I see how the story is told. So I consume it as reading a textbook. Because I see now he presents the character, now it's a pose, now, and I get a lot of inspiration for editing from movies.
Ok, per riassumere molto brevemente, le interessa più il cinema della fotografia. Lui normalmente non va a vedere mostre fotografiche, va a vedere film, perché si ispira dalla struttura dei film, e poi legge libri.
Well done. Yeah, yeah, yes. More questions? No, I don't know. I just have this series made in New Zealand. I think I might continue to work a little bit more on landscape because doing a series about landscape in New Zealand is quite limited. And if I want to talk about landscape, because I talk about documentary, I talk about street photography, and now I'm talking about landscape, I think I need to spend some more time and think, I mean, New Zealand is a very good place for landscape. Maybe I need to go to other very good place for landscape and see what happens. So it is a good start. I am happy with it. I am very excited with the results. But I don't think I have enough concept or things to say just with this, even if I have 100 images that I like.
Quindi ancora non sa se l'ha detto che saranno pubblicate, non si sa come, insomma, perché ha bisogno di più tempo per pensare. Come ha detto, i paesaggi non le piacciono, quindi queste foto possono essere un buon punto d'inizio, ma non racchiudono abbastanza concetti per pensare di fare un altro libro.
More questions? Yes, I took the sabbatical year in 2011. In 2011 I was in China, in Palestine, and in London, and in Italy. I was just traveling and doing the Afronauts. And 2012 I did the Afronauts in May, it was published. And yes, I think I moved in February. I moved all my things in February 2011, but then I traveled a lot. So all my things are in London, but not me.
Quindi l'anno sabbatico c'è stato nel 2011. Diciamo che si è trasferita a Londra nel febbraio 2011, però poi nel 2011 è stata in Cina, in Palestina e in Italia, quindi a Londra c'è stata molto poco. Poi nel 2012 è uscito Gli Afronauti e diciamo che al momento tutte le sue cose sono a Londra meno se stessa.
More questions? Then, thank you.